servant with the Ministry of Youth and Sports captured in the investigative police piece on corruption in football by Anas Aremeya Anas has been presented with a Civil and Local Government Staff Association CLOCSAG Award for Integrity 2019. The protocol officer, Dinah Dakou Aboateng, was seen rejecting bribe in the number 12 documentary. Where by your insistence on the right procedures to be followed in the face of supposed entrapment and the gentle smile with which you rejected the inducement, you have brought hope and honor to your colleagues who are faced with this ethical dilemma every day. End quote. Well, Maxwell Agbagba was at that event and he's got more in this report.
Media, as individual as you can, but CLOCSAG can join the media on the conversation around ex gratia. I think that thing must stop. If it must not stop, everybody must get it. Because it is not acceptable that somebody that we were together the last time, he joined ECO and became MP. The next 4 years, he's the richest man in the district. Why? And apart from that, he's going to get ex-gratia 1, ex-gratia 2, ex-gratia 3. Why? I don't think that it is fair. As a country, we must be fair to all of us because we matter. And I say we must be fair to all of us because we are all constitutionally mandated agencies of the state. And therefore, when it is about appropriating the resources of the nation for all the agencies must be treated well.
The Nathan Anang Kwal Hall at the CLOCSAG head office, where some members of the singing band made up of civil servants are treating guests to some music. In Anas Aremeya Anas's expose, an unseen individual is seen handing over wad of cash on the table of the protocol officer of the sports ministry. The money was to get her to help with visas for some unofficial persons. She rejected the cash and gave it back to the man who dropped it on the table. Dinah's strength to resist the temptation has earned her the 2019 Nathan Anang Kwal Award for Integrity.
The number 12 documentary shook the foundation of Ghana's football industry. Over 70 referees were caught on tape taking bribes. Depending on where you stand, you may as well describe them as gifts. What brought shame to many has brought honor to Dakou Aboateng.
Dinah Dakou Aboateng has been talking about the moment she realized she was captured in the documentary.
Remembered when I saw the video, and I was so surprised because I wasn't expecting myself to be part of that. I mean, I was so surprised. Yeah, he came there with the money, and we had a discussion, and then I actually told him, no, I don't work like that. My professional ethics doesn't allow me to take anything. So, I mean, I just gave it back to him.
But later when you saw it on TV, what was going through your mind that it could have been you in that situation?
Yes. When I saw it, I don't know. I was short of words. I couldn't just imagine the person's thoughts. I mean, what brought him there? You see, I don't know. We should always work with our professional ethics. We should always be as honest, truthful, and ready to save.
Dinah's husband, George Boateng, is proud of his wife.
I least expected to see her, but I feel so proud today to see her having this award today. I feel very proud. Okay. We give thanks to God. The family is proud of her. Everybody is proud of her.
Maxwell Agbagba with that report. Well, joining us in the studio for more on this is Deputy Executive Secretary of CLOCSAG, Kojo Krakeni. Mr. Krakeni, thank you so much for joining us this morning. How do you feel? This is the second time you're doing this award ceremony, and you had the opportunity to honor and recognize this woman for her action.
Yeah. We feel fine because we are aware that a nation that fails to honor its heroes is not worth dying for at all. And in the civil service, in the local government service, we have a lot of people who have actually worked hard, sometimes at the peril of their lives. When you look at the areas where we have conflicts in the north, sometimes we have civil servants in there working day and night, 24/7. But nobody remembers to honor us. We have other national awards. Farmers awards, teachers awards, whatever awards, instituted by the state. Nobody does that for civil servants. So in our own little way, we do our scouting and instituted this one to encourage our people that, no, we have not forgotten you. Then we tell the others sitting behind that people are still watching you. Keep on doing whatever you are doing and do it well.
So you'd have rather wished that there was a more nationalistic approach to this award scheme.
Nationalistic approach where you are aware that the nation is recognizing you for all work done, even with the past salary.
We'll come to that because you have a lot of challenges. I mean, anybody goes on to Google and types Clock Sagu, see all your concerns that you've raised over the years. There's been even times when you went on strike.
Several times you've been on strike.
But
military rule to democracy.
Do you feel that you are not given the space to do your work as civil servants? Do you feel handicapped?
Yeah, not in all cases, but in certain cases where we have a lot of political interference and political influences in some of the ministries and departments, to the extent that you have something we call personal assistants.
Yes.
Political appointees.
You've had issues with that.
Yeah. And apart from the fact that we have challenges with resources to work with, that one aside, we have undue interference in our work. You bring on board people who are not employed as civil servants. You get it. We have a big bouquet of professions in the civil service. It is actually the engine, the machinery of government business. So we have variety of professions. And the politicians come with other people thinking that for reasons best known to them, they come to encumber our jobs. If I am the principal accountant, for example, or chief accountant, or chief director, or senior accountant, then you bring somebody to come and work.
Mr. Krakeni, let me come in here because the perception, the general perception of civil servants by many people I have spoken to and on many of our programs where we have invited the public to share their thoughts, especially on civil servants, it's not too positive. Let me paint a picture. Some will say, oh, go to our civil service, civil servant's office. They come late, they leave earlier than they're supposed to. You go meet them, they're either holding lotto papers. I mean, there's a certain perception. Truthfully and honestly, when you compare persons within Clock Sag and the other persons that these politicians will usually want to bring in as personal assistants and, you know, other people to do the work that civil servants can do, do you think that the civil servants are a match for these persons, or they actually need to build their capacity to meet the demands of the time?
You are giving me two scenarios. One about the capacity, one about the perception about the public. Of the civil servant. In most cases, the name has just give us a bad name because the politician has his own agenda. So it gives...
But people come to your offices. They come
to
the ministries. They experience civil servants.
If you go to the civil service offices now, you won't see anybody working lotto. You don't see people coming in late because we are clocking in and clocking out. You don't see people loitering again. It used to be some time ago where people actually don't work. It's only few. But, you know, one time experience can give a bad impression about...
First impressions.
But we are saying that that is not the situation now. But I am working for a long time, and I've been going through promotions. People assess me they do appraisals and promote me. Now you bring in somebody because you felt of that perception. No, we are telling you that we are on the ground.
Mm.
Politicians, not all politicians bring people to the offices. It's not all politicians. Do you get it? If you listen to what Professor said yesterday, a lot of people know that there are time-tested people. That's why we are awarding them, that they have resisted the storms of the politicians. And therefore, you can't tell us that we are below the belt.
Mm.
We have people who are working. The guy we honored, the Nathan Kwao, whose memory we have instituted this thing, has worked under several politicians and several governments.
Mm.
And we have a lot of such people, some retired, some in the system.
Mm.
They resist the storm and they work hard,
mm.
even under the limited resources.
Mm. So you're saying that you're up to par, or even better?
We are always better. Let me tell you, there are a lot of scenarios.
Mm.
The people they bring in as consultants come to pick or copy what the civil servants have already done. And then give it a name as a consultancy. We have a lot of scenarios like that.
So how do we correct this perception? You're just telling us that now you have people clocking in and out, but the perception remains. I should open the phone lines now, I am pretty sure that people will still share experiences they've had of civil servants, which is not
corrected. If you get to the local government service, they have a code of ethics. If you go to the head of civil service, office of head of civil service right now, we have code of ethics. And there are certain things that are in place that are checking people who are actually not working well.
Mm.
And we have disciplinary committees. And you are supposed to be subjected to those type of things.
And so you punish people?
Yes,
people
we punish people. We have client service offices, client service officers, client service centers and units taking care of people. We still know that even when I'm coming to this office, I can meet such people who may not be so happy and warmly as expected.
Mm.
But we always do in-service training for our people to be up to the task.
Mm. You made reference to Professor Justice Bowley, he's the incoming dean of the Ghana Business School at the University of Ghana, Lagos. And he mentioned something, and I realized there was a lot of applause in the room. He spoke about ex gratia and said that if civil servants don't have ex gratia, there's no point politicians having ex gratia because you're all considered civil servants in a way. You agree with him as clock sack.
Yeah. And I'm sure you're also going to agree with us. Because ex gratia simply means thank you for good work done. Thank you for the sacrifices. Thank you for commitment. And the last one is thank you for your integrity and loyalty for working for the state for all this work. That's the meaning of ex gratia, the way I understand it. So therefore, there shouldn't be any discrimination in the award of ex gratias in the public services, including the political public services.
Mm.
So when you look at the pension system that they give to civil servants or any other in the public services, local government service, health service, all those places, it depends, it is contributory.
Yes.
Therefore, it is hinging on your
salary.
Your salary. And if you look at the civil servant salary, it's about the lowest. So you understand what I mean? And what they give to the politicians after 4 years, I'm talking specifically about the MPs, after 4 years, it's about 450 times what somebody thinks as a lump sum after 40 years or 30 years in the public service. And they take it after 4 years. When you're able to be brought back to parliament, another 4 years, take 400,000 Ghana Cedi.
Mm.
You see, so when we are doing something that is not having a basis of equity, there is always confusion, there is always suspicion, there is always, you are boiling something you cannot control in the long run. So we are saying that, well, somebody will tell you, they have the politicians or the MPs have the way of defending theirs. But we are also looking at it that it is just too huge a gap. It's a recipe for me.
So are you satisfied if they reduce their ex gratia and still don't give you any ex gratia civil servants? Or you're demanding that at all costs you should get ex gratia? But I'm asking you from the point of clock sack. Are you asking that at all costs you deserve that thank you? Because you've mentioned that some of your colleagues are in very bad situations in other parts of the country and they're sacrificing a lot.
Yeah.
So are you saying at all costs give us ex gratia?
Yeah. They have to give us. they have to give us the ex gratia.
Your voice sounds a bit low on this particular one. I'm not.
They should give us. Do you know why I sound so? There is always a, if you are an employee of government, that is the saddest thing for you to be an employee of government. Your government is your employer. They give certain flimsy excuses that the wage bill is too high, civil servants are too many, and therefore if you want to give us criteria at that rate, you can see the quantum. They start giving such excuses. But if you are going to ask for what is given to the MPs, I'm just thinking as to what the Minister of Finance is going to say, or the budget is going to say about it. But if anything at all, we should not be treated differently from the politicians. After all, the risk at all levels is the same. Whatever you find at this, a DCE working, or an MPE working, in the conflict zone, in the constituencies, in the district, you find civil servants working there.
Well, if you just joined us, this is a conversation we are having about CLOCSAC. Mr. Krakani is Executive Secretary Deputy Executive Secretary, thank you, of the association. And he's been telling us that if you have the perception that civil servants are lazy, go to work late, leave earlier than they should, that is changing. And that's the education he's given us here. And he's telling us why they deserve ex gratia, even as the politicians take it. But let me just come down to the awards event you had yesterday. You awarded this lady who was spotted in that Anas Arimeya Anas video rejecting bribe. This is somebody you have identified through the help of a journalist. But what about the many other people who are sitting in their offices who may have rejected similar offers? How are you planning to spot them? How are you planning to identify and award such persons?
Thank you. We have a scouting system, and it is not like a one-spot type of scouting system. We track a few people, some of the people who work in the district. If I'm looking for somebody like you to award, I'll start investigating from where you started working, the stations that you worked, and then up to the last station. Then we find a way of getting the needed rapport about you that is suitable for the things that we are measuring. We measure your neutrality, like somebody who has resisted neutrality, your integrity, you resist the corruption, then professionalism. If you are talking about coming to work early and then working even beyond the close time, professionally, then excellence. We have a way of watching them. Now we are even partnering with the Office of the Head of Civil Service and the Office of the Local Government Service, who have gotten ways of appraising their staff, starting from the chief directors down to the lower rank. So we use that one. But the CLOCSAC itself has its way. When I go out to work in WA, for example, 2 weeks ago, I started looking out for people in such lines. So we will certainly reach out to people who are there. We cannot award everybody, but we award people who are actually deserving. So we are appealing to our people that they should get it easy. To come to the attend.
It's to come to the attend.
To come to the attend. Because we sponsor it and we want to have it lasting forever.
Are you hoping to have such strict events, like probably testing your own people to see if they would accept bribes or not, or getting people to do those kind of really hardcore investigation?
Own way of determining. Finding out whether we have a lot of things that we do.
Thank you very much, Mr. Krakani. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. I'm Bernice Abubedu Lansa, and this is News Desk. Mr. Krakani is Deputy Executive Secretary of CLOCSAC, and we've been talking about awarding civil servants who show a lot of professionalism, excellence, and integrity in their work, even as they did yesterday for that woman you see in your shorts there, who was seen in an Anas video rejecting bribe. Well, we'll keep our eyes on CLOCSAC, and hopefully they'll be able to get their demands, especially seeking ex gratia from the state and government.